Hi
Hi
guys.
guys, we're doing something different today.
We are going to introduce to you Sneha from Wonder Woman Wednesdays.
Thank you so much. At the heart of every successful business lies the mastery of customer acquisition. Today on Beyond Her Story, we are diving into the vibrant world of pop-up events with Shima Zohra and Lina Nair, the dynamic duo behind the pop-up project. Launching from their original concept unicorn pop-ups, they have now crafted a series of innovative and community-driven events that not only spotlight local entrepreneurs, but also create a hub for customers seeking unique and local products. Shima Zohra brings a decade of experience as a fashion designer and makeup artist, armed with an acute eye for detail that she believes makes all the difference. And Lina Nair offers a blend of architectural precision and artistic flair to every event they curate. And together they form a formidable team that focuses on creating not just events but memorable experiences that help businesses thrive. In today's conversation, let us understand the journey of the pop-up project and how it is helping a lot of small business owners and entrepreneurs to market their products. Welcome, Lina and Shima, to be on Her Story on Wonder Woman Wednesday. It's such a pleasure to have you both on this show.
Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting us.
Yeah, I think we are excited to start the interview and ask you about how, you know, it all began and the story behind the pop-up project. So, shall we begin?
Absolutely. Sure. We have a very interesting story, actually. So, yeah, we would love to tell you about it.
Lina and Shima, let us start from the beginning. Like, how did your journey start? Because I know, you know, Shima is a fashion designer and a makeup artist, and you're an architect. And the pop-up project is something totally different, right? So, how did that happen?
Inspiration, I think basically Shima and I were sitting one day and talking about our small business and how to promote it, and ta-da, pop-up project was born. So
literally in 5 minutes, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
So how it happened, right? It
yeah.
was it, you came home one day and we just started, and I was like, how do we promote our small business? Let's do something.
Yeah.
And then you just came up with, like, why don't we have pop-ups?
Yeah,
and why don't we get
basically
everybody
our idea
along?
Was initially just to have us. Two of us and a few of our friends put it together, and then we're like, you know, there's so many small brands out there which require this. Why should we not have a bigger thing? And yeah. That's how, and we are 10 edits down now, and this is not something that we thought was going to happen at all. So, yeah, it was literally one edit at a time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure, you know, when you curate this pop-up project and create the event, it's not easy, right? And I'm sure there are a lot of challenges that come along the way. So, what are the most common challenges that you face when you want to curate an event and anything along the journey that you found?
Actually, I know it sounds difficult to believe that we didn't think too much about it, and we just went into it head on. So we thought of the idea. By next day, we were thinking of a name, and the name also just happened, like, literally organically. And then we were like, okay, we'll put together people, we'll start off. So we didn't think of anything as a challenge. We didn't even know venues in Bangalore when we started out, like where we should go. We only thought of one place, and we're like, okay, let's go take a car there, go see the place. If that doesn't work, let's go to the next place. Literally was happening like that. And so I think we were very excited about it. We didn't think of any of it as a challenge. We went with the flow and everything fell into place.
Yeah, and we had a lot of support with from our friends also.
Yes, yeah.
And one of our friends told us about BIC. We went and looked at BIC, and our first pop-up was there. And it just happened.
We went there. We took the car. We went there. We met the secretary and asked, are these dates free?
Yeah.
And we were like, are we free on those dates? Okay, done. It was that. So starting out was not the challenge. But now that we've been doing this for more than 10 edits, there are a few challenges we are facing now.
Yeah.
Right?
Most important challenge is the first question when we approach a vendor, you know, to take part in our pop-ups and stuff. The first question is, what's the footfall? I wish I knew. I wish I could predict the future.
Yeah.
But yeah, footfall is something we cannot predict, because in Bangalore especially, there are like so many pop-ups happening, and there are so many things. Like, kids have exams, there are holidays, you know,
festivals,
so many festivals,
so many things.
And so many things.
And people just go out of town in Bangalore, like, you know, you give them one long weekend and everyone's out. So it's like a really tough thing to predict. We try our best, but we can't tell you footfall.
So, based on your experience of creating and curating so many pop-ups, what are the best strategies that you use for marketing your pop-up project?
See, we've actually tried radios, we've tried paper, newspaper and everything. But what we've realized is Instagram is the most fast reaching medium to the audience. So right now we do a lot on lot of paid promotions on Instagram to market.
And then, of course, reels and more reels.
Yeah.
I think we started out realizing that plays a very important role. And initially she was extremely shy. I am not shy and I can just go on talking. We just have to stop me. But she's come a long way. It's amazing. So the first one, she's really like all sweaty, all nervous. Now we do the reels, and she's pro. Now we do it alone, we do it together, anywhere. I mean, we go somewhere and Chima's like, this place looks nice, let's take a reel here. So so not just has it made a difference for the pop-up project, I think big difference to Chima.
And now we're sitting here talking, doing this. At the camera.
I have one question on that. The trend is that, every business owner has to dance and do things on the reel. What are your thoughts?
Hi guys.
Yeah, that's our what is it called? Catchphrase or whatever. I'm going to try and make Chima dance soon, but
really?
till then it's only hi guys. But yeah. You're right. I mean, I think the trending songs, the trending music. So we try and play the trending music in all our reels, at that time. And the trending changes so quickly. So everything has to be like current and everything has to be. And that's something we are learning. This is not something that we started knowing how to do, but learning, it's like, so she knows one part of it, which is all the paid promotions. Everything is taken care of by her, because everything from setting location to demographic and everything is taken care of by her. I do the reels. So we kind of split our responsibilities like that. And it's been working pretty fine. And like I said, we've gotten comfortable.
Yeah.
Dancing is still pending.
Yeah, but most of our vendors, they come and say hi guys to us, because they know us. I mean, they know us that way now, they recognize us that way. And then sometimes they're like, who's Lina and who's Chima?
Yeah, that's the only confusion.
Yeah.
And it's really nice, because now when we have pop-ups, there are people who have watched the reels who come and say, hi, we watch your reels, you're Lina and Chima, right? And both of us are like, wow, you actually just watch it and you come. So we are still overwhelmed with the whole thing, but it feels so good. It feels really good that people do that.
So when curating pop-ups, I think the most important thing is to have vendors, right? And the participation of vendors is one of the most important aspects. So how do you manage to get the vendors? What is your criteria for selecting the vendors?
So once we post, once we announce it on Instagram, we announce only on Instagram. We don't mail anybody, any vendors. So once we do it, it's like we start getting inquiries, then we get the details about the brand, about their products, and then we sit every Saturday, we sit together and we go through all the brands, their products, and then the first thing is we see the quality of the products.
One of the things that we do is, because we curate, we try and make sure that we look at where the spaces, whether it's in Koramangala, in Ranagar or Cunningham Road, or where we're having the pop-up, and the space, and what product will be best suited to the space. So we get a lot of inquiries, and now we've come up with a system. So as pop-up to pop-up, we learn new things. So now we have a system where we have we ask them to fill out about their product, their Instagram page or website, the contact numbers, etc. So we sit, and like she was saying, every Saturday we sit and we go through all of them and see what fits into the current pop-up that we are curating. And quality of the product, sustainability, all of that is extremely important. And also, I think for us, it's a big thing about how we vibe. When we are talking to that person, we usually, if we shortlist the brands, we have calls, we sit together and call everyone, and you get a feel when you are talking to someone, like whether they are connecting with us or not. And if they do, we are like, this works.
And the best thing is, whichever brand we try to take, we first talk about it. Will we use it?
Yeah.
Will we, like to give it to our kids or our family? It all depends on all those criteria also, because that's really important. We don't want to just have some vendor who comes and keeps something that we are not sure of, So we like to first try it ourselves, and then...
Testimony to that is, if you see the way I shop at any of our pop-ups, I mean, it's, I can't help it also. So I'm already looking forward. When we select the vendors, only I'm telling her, she also tells me, this person you should not go near because I'll be shopping. And yeah, that's what normally happens. So as you can see, we really believe in all the products and vendors that we have at all
and
our
pop-ups.
And
when we see the products and this is something really nice, and we're like, Lee, this is nice. We have to get this.
She's also slowly becoming a shopper. She was not as an impulsive shopper as I was.
I'm not a shopaholic at all.
But now she is slowly converting.
One other thing about having these pop-up events is that, you need to foster a sense of community between your vendors and your customers and all that. So how is it that you managed to build that community?
So when we started off with the Pop-Up project, I think one of our aims was to have a community where all of us help each other. And in small ways, I think we've achieved that, because a lot of times at Pop-Up, we've noticed that when people are setting up their tables, everyone comes together and helps, saying that, you know what, maybe you should shift this here. And everyone's open to it. And, you know, when you see that happening in front of you, Shima and I are standing there beaming. It just feels great. And there was this one instance where she was having a really bad cough at one of the Pop-Ups. And one of the vendor's mums, who, I mean, she's taken part with us multiple times, so we know her really well. She went out, this was at BIC, so she went to the gardens, found a beetle leaf and told her, chew on the beetle leaf because it'll really help your cough. I mean, I found that amazing, like, you know, who goes out of the way like that, leaves your stall, walks around, looks for this and comes and gives it to her. And it was amazing to see that.
Yes. And, you know, we've had pop-ups days like where on the same day, one vendor is doing really well and the other one is like has not sold even a piece from them. That's when you see the other vendors who've done well coming to them and, you know, talking to them and, you know, trying to boost their morale. And, you know, they keep encouraging them. Oh, maybe today was like that. Maybe tomorrow will be good for you. And, you know, things like that. It's very nice to see how everybody supports each other. And it's kind of becoming a small extended family.
It feels really good to see that happening. I think that was our aim and we didn't know how to go about it, but it somehow happened organically that that's what it is. And last pop-up, we had some vendors who had taken part earlier drop in. They didn't take part with us this time, but they dropped in. They were standing at some of the stalls helping others. We all took a selfie together. It was, I mean, it's really nice to see that happen. We get overwhelmed. I mean, at least I get like really overwhelmed seeing it.
It's so nice to see everybody helping each other,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
It's very... very rare to see in this nowadays. There's so much competition between businesses,
yeah.
And when you see your businesses supporting each other, then it's like really nice.
It's like one of those Instagram quotes and all that you get, you know, you uplift each other. That actually happens,
yeah,
and it's like awesome.
It happens at the Pop-Up project.
Yeah, it happens at the Pop-Up project.
So, with so many curated events and curated pop-ups, I'm sure you would have met a lot of business women, small business owners, and you would have interacted with them, right? And I'm sure you would understand a lot of things on the things that go on in their mind as well. So what advice would you give to the entrepreneurs on how they should market their product? Is there anything that they should know when they come for these kind of pop-ups and even otherwise?
One of the things that I've seen, more than marketing, see, if you're an entrepreneur and going to start off, there are so many doubts and thoughts and things which come into your head. And from our experience, I can tell you very clearly, do not overthink it. Do not overthink it. Things will fall in place if you really believe in what you're doing. And it's amazing to see everybody believes in their product. Everybody is saying, as long as you have a quality product and you really believe in it, don't overthink. Just go ahead.
In terms of marketing, I would say cross-marketing. You know, cross-marketing really helps. So I have a brand, Lina has a brand, I market her brand, she markets my brand. You know, it reaches a lot more audiences that way. And that helps each other. You know, one thing I would say, don't get overwhelmed with competition. You know, it's like competition is good, but
everybody's product is unique.
Everybody's product is unique. Believe in your product, believe in yourself,
and the rest falls into place.
So Lina and Shima, it's been amazing. Now I'm excited to know about your next pop-up. Where is it and when is it, if you can just share it?
So our next one is at Cafe Reset, Kormanda, Shopaholic September on the 27th and 28th.
Oh, wow, that's just 1 week from now.
Yes,
yeah. Too many times of repeating 27th and 28th. Yeah. So we don't want any of you to forget. Neha will be coming.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I wish all of you to come. And we're again curating a very interesting selection. And this is our festive edit, which we always get very excited. We are actually excited about all edits, but festive to be
fun.
Festive. So hoping to see all of you there. Please do join us.
I'm excited. I think I'll be there for sure.
Oh, awesome. One footfall down.
So I think Lina and Shima, this has been an amazing conversation. So much chemistry between the two of you, and the way you're passionate. I can see that in the way you speak. And I've actually seen your reels on Instagram too. I do follow you. So
And I see that, you know, you're constantly promoting the brands that are a part of your pop-ups. And that's so good to see. Like you said, uplifting each other, I think it makes a lot of difference. So thank you for sharing your journey and sharing all the, whatever you're doing, the tips and the advice to the entrepreneurs. And I'm sure, you know, it'll bring a lot of value to the viewers watching it. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
So, yeah, this is fun. We didn't think it was going to be like such fun to do, actually. We enjoyed ourselves a lot. And I think got to know a little more about our own enterprise as well. So
thank you so much.
Thank you.